Hello guys, and welcome back to another cold episode. On today's episode, as you can tell by the title and the thumbnail, I have two cards that I thoroughly do not enjoy, not only in Master Duel, but in every format. Two cards. That's it. These are the cards that I would say cause the most issues with enjoying a game. That is Maxi. I think this one is pretty self-explanatory, and the second is Called By. We'll get to Called By in a second, but let's talk about Maxi. Now, I'm sure most of you who have played Master Duel or the OCG are well familiar with this card and why it is so annoying. Being able to draw cards when your opponent special summons is absolutely crazy. And if we look at the OCG, Master Duel, and the like, you have to play so many outs to this card because of how prevalent and how game determinative this singular card is. Now, this card alone ends turns and wins games, which in a best of three format is not that big of a deal. So if you're playing in the TCG or the OCG, it's not nearly as disruptive as it is in Master Duel. In Master Duel, you have to main deck normally about 6 to 8 cards to deal with just this one. Okay, maybe not 6 to 8, 5 to 8 cards. Triple Ash, double Called By, because it's at 2, and triple Crossout. With these ratios, you can actually relatively easily deal with Maxi. And the reason you need to do this is because if your opponent drops a Maxi and you don't have the out, oftentimes you lose. Either your opponent draws too many cards, or you end on a weaker board. So this card, by itself, with no costs, with no restrictions, with nothing like that, causes the game to not just slow down, it doesn't just stop combo decks. What it does is it stops turns, and it changes the tide of the battle, and it changes the way that decks have to be built. When a card requires 8 answers, or 8 slots in your deck, in order to out it, it becomes a problem, right? And I know, everyone makes the argument, it stops combo. It doesn't. It doesn't stop combo. It hinders deck building, and it hinders diversity within combo, control, and the like strategies, because you have to play so many outs to it. You have to be prepared to play against it, to play through it, right? And again, in best of threes, it's not nearly as big of a deal, because again, you can play more outs in the side deck, you can play around it. If your opponent doesn't draw it, it's fine. It's a three of, it's not like they're going to draw it every game. So it's not something where it's like as match determinative, because there are a lot of ways to play around it in a best of three. But in best of ones in particular, which is what I mostly play, what a lot of people mostly play for Master Duel, it is a massive problem. Now, I know a lot of you don't like Maxi. And I'm sure some of you who have played the TCG, where Maxi is not an issue, are not a fan of this card as well. Called By the Grave. And I'm sure so many of you are wondering what I am talking about when I say I don't like Called By. So, I'm going to give you an analogy that has nothing to do with Yu-Gi-Oh! Imagine, if you will, you are a professional soccer player, or football player. Sorry. You're a professional football player. And at the start of the game, a coin flip is decided. And with this coin flip, the coach of each team has a chance to draw or to get a free red card on any player, on any position on the opponent's team. Okay? So what happens? Start of the game, they flip the coin, it's tails. Your opponent gets this red card. Now what they do is they red card you out of the game. You no longer get to play the game. And it's not just you, that position is empty. Meaning, if you play defense, all of a sudden, you're down a defender. If you played a striker position, you are now out. You cannot play that position. That entire position is empty. That is what Called By the Grave feels like. Because if you only have 1 or 2 hand traps, a single Called By prevents your opponent from even being interacted with. Right? So, If you try to Ash Blossom your opponent on a key card, like for example, a Crystal on Helka Thibrax, and a Called by the Grave comes down, you no longer get that interaction. And I hear you saying, well, Crossout does the same thing. The difference is, with Called by, you can also activate it on other cards in Grave that your opponent may be targeting. Say they drop a Monster Reborn, they're targeting their big boss monster that was in the grave that you sent there. You dealt with it, now you Called by it, it no longer is there, right? Say they want to reborn another thing from the graveyard through other means, you can Called by it. Say they want to activate something on the field that has a monster of the same name in the grave, you Called by it, right? It takes away an entire form of interaction from the game. Unlike Crossout, you don't have to deck build around the card. You can just hit it while it's in the graveyard. This means that oftentimes, just this single form of interaction is enough to prevent or to prevent any interaction on a combo deck that can already play through one or two forms of interaction, right? For example, yes, it can, you know, if you go into Crystron Halka Fibrax, that's the choke point, right? Oftentimes in decks, you go into Crystron Halka Fibrax, that's the choke point. So if your opponent were to hand trap that, sometimes it ends your turn. That is good. That means that the game is healthy. But with Called by, it doesn't 90% of the hand traps that you would want to interact with, except for specifically Imperm, are hit by Called by, right? So if you activate Called by, you hit them all except for like one card, I guess two, because Nibiru as well. But at that point, you may not have already had Nibiru. Maybe you have a Negate up, etc., etc. But the fact of the matter is, yes, this does stop Max C, which is why I don't want to get rid of this card if Max C is legal. I think this card is necessary because of Max C. But because of the way that combo decks in particular have worked out, they can play through one or two hand traps, things like an Ash Blossom and things like a Ghost Ogre. They can play through those and still make a fairly decent board. But the point of hand traps is to slow your opponent down to where you can start playing with less cards in hand, but against a less impressive board, against a weaker board, sorry. And Called by, in particular, really does slow that down. Crossout, not so much. It still hurts, but it's not as impactful. It's still one of my least favorite cards because it does stop that form of interaction, which really combo decks don't need. So that's my argument for these two cards and why I personally am not a fan of them in particular. And I know a lot of you are going to be like, well, have you played against Flunderese? Well, have you played against Adventure Engine? Yes, I have. I've played against them in the TCG and in this game. I know I've played against Splites. I've played against Terra Elements. I've played against these decks. I know what they're like. I know these cards. And these two consistently are the most game determinative. And that's all I basically wanted to say. Just these two cards are such a big deal and change the outcome of the game so often that I would really like to see both of them hit on every ban list and put to zero. It's one of those things where it doesn't seem like they're absolutely insane, except for Maxi, but they really do just change the way that the game is played. That's all. I'm sure that some of you disagree and say that Called by is absolutely necessary. You have to have it. I want to be able to play my combo decks, and to that I say, sure. But also, it's not really that big of a deal. Yes, sometimes you're going to have dead hands, and you're not going to be able to play through hand traps, but that's kind of the point. Anyway, that's all. Hope that you guys did indeed enjoy this episode. I just wanted to kind of get this off of my chest and kind of get it out there. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you did, a like is very much so appreciated, and if you want to check out more content like this, as well as more Yu-Gi-Oh!, then just be sure to subscribe. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and remember to always stay frosty. Bye-bye.